Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler. I want to take a few minutes to show you a brand new motorhome we just took in here. This is a 2021 Asada 3, or excuse me, this is a Sunseeker. Get that correct there. So this is a 2021 Sunseeker built by Forest River. This is a company that's part of Berkshire Hathaway, so we like the fact that they're a solid financially backed company as part of Warren Buffett's empire. So we like to put products on our lot that are good products but also are backed by companies that have some good financial footing. So it just makes it that much easier to feel comfortable with the fact that they're going to be around for a while. Warren Buffett runs out of money, I guess. Probably not going to really matter too much. But in the meantime, we'll hope that doesn't happen. But notice the really nice full body paint. This is a beautiful coach. Nice combination between livability and drivability. A lot of people like this chassis. It's built on the Mercedes Sprinter chassis. Six-cylinder turbo diesel engine. It's economical, easy to drive. It's something you can get in and out of a lot of spots. The model is a 24B. So it's probably a little over 24 feet, say around 25 feet overall length. So easy to maneuver, easy to handle, fun to drive, and very economical. Lots of safety features. We'll talk about those a little bit more when we go inside the motorhome. Nice awning on this unit. It has an LED light strip. You can kind of see in there. It's not lit up right now, but that's really nice. You can move that awning out, or even if the awning's in, right now like it is, you can still use that light strip to light up the side of the coach. So the thing that's really nice about this too is it's already wired for portable solar panels. So if you want to maybe, you know, you do a little dry camping but you're not a boondocker most of the time, it'd be kind of nice to have something you can just plug into the side of your coach. You got these little portable solar panels, you just open them up, keeps your batteries charged up while you're out using your motorhome. Of course, if you can do full-on solar if you choose to do that, roof mount. But for the most part, people are going to be plugged in when they're using a coach like this. Backup monitor has side view cameras also. One-piece fiberglass roof. I think that's a big plus. That's something to mention. Some motorhome manufacturers will use like a TPO, kind of a vinyl roof or a rubber roof. This is a lot better application when you have the vinyl roof or the fiberglass roof. You know, it's much more durable, less likely you're going to poke a hole in it. Got a little quick connect back here too for propane, so you could plug in a barbecue back there. It's already set up for towing. Got a ladder to get up on top in case you need to get up there and do any cleaning or servicing. It's always good to check your caulking around your vents and that type of thing. It's a one-piece seamless roof, so you don't have a lot of issues to deal with there, but you know, the caulking around your air conditioning and vents sometimes can get a little brittle. Water connection right here. You can use that for spraying down your feet or something, or if you're at the beach before you go in your coach. Here's where you plug in your 30 amp cord. Another place here for the sewer hose, and then here's your dump holes. We've got water connections here. You got city water, and then this is a black tank flush, and here's where you plug in for cable. It does have an onboard, looks like it's locked. Don't have a key to get in it, but there is a generator in there. You got a 3600 LP generator. Here's your power cord. A little bit of storage in here. Got a light in there as well. Some more storage here. What's nice about this coach too, it's got a full wall slide over here. It's a pretty big slide. Once we go inside, you'll see the advantage to that is it opens up really well. There's a nice big storage compartment there also. And you have one on the other side. It's about the same size. a little storage compartment here. So we're trying to utilize the space really well. And your propane tank's right in there. Really a nice, pleasant paint job. Side view cameras, I mentioned it has those, and then you got the backup monitor. Really nice lines. It's a little newer styling. This is the newer chassis, so it's got the 19.5 model Sprinter chassis. So it's the latest and greatest in the Mercedes chassis on the Sprinter line. Has a lot of features that you'd get on their automobiles. So as far as safety features, something that hasn't been real common in the RV industry, but it is now in some manufacturers, primarily Mercedes. We're going to take a look inside, but I also want to just kind of throw out there too, if you have questions, give me a call. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. That's my direct line, so give me a shout. So as we enter in, we can see there's controls right here. It has a battery disconnect, so I can, which is off right now, if I want to use my lights or whatever inside the coach, I can just use that. It's got electric stabilizers for the rear. You've got some controls here for lighting. The awning control is right there. That is an electric awning. As you come up, you can see it's a little different cockpit than what they've had in the prior models before they came out with this 19.5 model. Yeah, even though it's a 21 model motorhome, or just refer to that chassis as the 19.5 because that's kind of when they made that change. It has power seats now, whereas before you didn't have that option. It has heated seats, controls on your steering column. It's very interactive with the computer system that's built in. It has a Mercedes computer system that has voice commands. You can, you know, if you're looking for the nearest Mexican restaurant, you want to go have Chinese food or whatever, you can just talk to Mercedes there and she'll help you find what you're looking for. Push button entry or start on this model now too. But some of the features that you'll really like, it does have lane assist, it has active cruise control, it has a system that'll turn your wipers on if it senses that there's enough moisture to warrant that. We'll talk about that a little bit more at another time. Like I said, you can call me if you have questions about any of that stuff. Nice, good sized bed up here. It even has some storage compartments and a couple of cup holders. Easy enough to just slide that out of the way. Both these front seats are going to spin around as well, and there are seat cushions that sit down on here. They're probably back in the closet to help you sit up a little bit further so your feet don't stick, you know, straight out. Nice wraparound dinette booth. Notice the big slide, so it covers pretty much this whole side of the coach. The wraparound dinette offers a good seating area for eating or just for hanging out. You can use it for your sofa or slash dinette. Nice full extension drawers. It's got a whole house water filter system. This will make into a bed too, so actually you can drop that and use your cushions to fill that in, and I have another sleeper, another drawer here. I like the way they come all the way out. They use heavy duty glides on their drawers too, so that helps a lot to be able to put some weight in there. And then you've got storage above here also. Another storage compartment here with some pull out drawers. Actually, your main clothes, there's areas back there. We'll take a look at that in just a second if we head that way, but let's just kind of work our way back there. Let's look at the storage here in the kitchen area. And I didn't really touch bases with you on this one here, but let's take a look just here and show you what I've got. So you got your controls right here too, so everything's pretty easy to get to, centrally located. If you want, turn on your water heater, you can do it right here. Has an electric element and or propane. Turn your water pump on. This one has an Arctic pack too, which is really nice. So if you get in some cold weather, you can, it's heated tank, so you can put heat to your holding tanks. Lighting control, slide out control here. And you can check all your tank levels as well. And also start your generator from in here. Here's your sound system, already your, and I think we touched the fact that it does have the TV in it already. Microwave convection oven, two burner stovetop, nice deep, one deep sink with a nice residential style faucet to go with it. Storage drawers, that's for your toilet paper holder. They usually don't put them in because you might want to, some people have different ideas on where they want to have their toilet paper holder. So this is really nice too. This is a newer style refrigerator. It's two doors, so you have freezer up on top and refrigerator down below. This operates off of 12 volts, so you don't have to worry about whether you have propane or not if you're out dry camping. And just like I said, you got a portable solar deal where you can keep your batteries charged up. Operates off your batteries on this one here. Your bathroom is a all private bath, so you got a nice shower with a natural light above it with the sunroof. Or again, kind of this one here. Tell I'm right-handed, can't you? There you go. Nice big cabinet for incidentals. Well, I guess this is an energy-efficient shower, for those of you that are interested in knowing that. TV back here, and I mentioned storage. Got a nice big closet. Here's another tabletop that you can use to put in between those two front seats. These are the cushions I mentioned, so you got two of those. It looks like it has screens for the front for privacy, and then you can hang clothes up in here too. And then you do have, there's the other side of that closet, some nice big drawers here too. Another cabinet down here, so pretty good amount of storage. Even has some shelf back in there that you can store some stuff. Maybe put something in there, a little place for maybe your water if you like to have a water bottle or something next to your bed while you're sleeping. It's nice to have some windows in here too. So a really nice layout. 24B is the model. It's kind of a newer floor plan. They've had something similar to this in the past. This is different. Yeah, give me a call. Love to tell you a little bit more about it, or maybe this looks like something that'll work for you. We'd be glad to work with you to see what we can do about getting you into it. Jim Beckler, 541-510-1017. Thank you.